Hello and welcome to yet another module on physical education. Today we are going to talk about the command method in physical education. The defining characteristic of the command style is precision, performance, reproducing a predicted response or performance on cue. In the anatomy of the command style, the role of the teacher is to make all the decisions and the role of the learner is to follow these decisions on cue. When this behavior is achieved, the following objectives are reached in the subject matter and in the behavior. The objective of subject matter are to reproduce a model by immediate performance, to achieve accuracy and precision of performance, to achieve immediate results, to achieve a synchronized performance, to adhere to a predetermined model, to master subject matter skills, to perpetuate cultural traditions and rituals, to use time efficiently, to cover more material. And the behavior objectives are to socialize the individual into the norms of the group, to achieve conformity, to achieve uniformity, to build group identity and pride, a sense of belonging, to enhance spirit de corps, to follow directions on cue, to achieve specific aesthetic standards, to develop habits and routines, to perpetuate cultural traditions, ceremonies and rituals, to control groups or individuals, to instill safety procedures, to adhere to a particular kind of discipline. Command style discipline, each behavior has its own form of discipline. The OTLO is the fundamental unit of relationships. The particular roles, decisions of the teacher and learner in the command style produce a particular set of outcomes. The outcomes can be compared to the anticipated set of objectives that this decision relationship produces to determine the degree of congruence, that is agreement, that occurred between the intended set of objectives and the actual classroom action. When any of the above objectives arise, the decision structure of the command style will lead to them. Some of the many examples that represent the decision structure of the command style include opening ceremony of the Beijing Olympic Games, synchronized swimming, synchro diving, classical ballet dancing, school figures in ice skating, crew in rowing, group calisthenics, performing in an orchestra, square, folk, line dancing, singing in a choir, pronouncing new words or words in another language, landing a plane on an aircraft carrier, acting in theater productions, participating in martial arts, trapeze performances, cheerleading, performing in a drill team, marching in a band, marching in military parades, dancing with the Radio City Rockets, precision flying with the Blue Angels, taking part in formal ceremonies, wedding, inaugural celebrations, funerals, etc. Precision parachuting. Few fields are as rich an example of the command style as physical education. Precision physical performances are represented in all aspects of the society. Some examples maintain traditions while others challenge them. Some examples are necessary for an orderly society while others are intended as entertainment. Regardless of the content, all share the same decision structure. The teacher, that is the leader or the authority figure, makes all the decisions while the participants or the learners or the performers execute the performance decisions on cue. The decisions are the defining factor that establishes the teaching-learning relationship and the ensuing objectives. Although Marston deliberately selected the name command style because it captured the essence of the style's decision relationship, the name is arbitrary. Marston could have named this first behavior any of the following: precision practice, cued response, imitation practice, follow the leader practice, choral responding practice, immediate response practice, boot camp practice, etc. What is the unwavering is the decision structure that defines the relationship. When the behavior of the teacher and the learner adheres to the anatomy of the command style, that behavior, independent of its arbitrary name, leads to objectives of this relationship. For some, the name command style produced a negative emotion that prevented them from acknowledging the validity of this teaching-learning behavior. The purpose of establishing landmark names for different teaching-learning behaviors is to establish a common language, a frame of reference that enables us to converse about teaching in a clear, efficient manner and to claim this jargon as our own, different from other teaching fields. The importance of any teaching-learning relationship is not its name, but the set of decisions that lead to educational objectives. The essence of the command style is the direct and immediate relationship between the teacher's stimulus and the learner's response. The stimulus, the command signal by the teacher, precedes every movement of the learner, who perform according to the model presented by the teacher. Hence, all the decisions listed in the anatomy of any style, subject matter, selection, location, posture, starting time, pace and rhythm, stopping time, duration and interval, feedback, etc., are made by the teacher. The implementation of the command style, the focal questions for the teacher who wishes to implement an episode or a series of episodes in the command style are: what is the picture of this kind of a relationship between a teacher and students? How does one translate the theoretical model, that is the intent, into actual teaching, that is learning behaviors or the actions? How does the teacher determine if the objectives of the style are reached? Let us start with a general description of an episode and then identify the steps needed to implement it. Description of an episode. An episode in the command style must reflect the essence of this relationship. The teacher makes all the decisions and the learner responds to each decision. In this episode, correspondence between the learner's behavior and the teacher's behavior is continuous for each and every performed movement. The teacher gives the command signal for each movement and the learner performs accordingly. Examples of this relationship can be observed in classes of karate, ballet, aerobics, and folk dances. Sometimes the command signal and the rhythm supported techniques are relegated to other people or to instruments such as the beat of the music in the aerobics, the drums in some folk dances, the coxswain in rowing, the student leading a class in warm-up exercises, and so on. The essence of the relationship is the same. One person or surrogate is making all the decisions for others. When this relationship exists, the objectives for the command style are reached. A teacher who wishes to use this style needs to be fully aware of the decision structure, the anatomy of the style, the sequence of the decisions, the possible relationships between command signals and expected responses, the appropriateness of the task, and the present level of ability of the learners, that is, their ability to perform the movements with reasonable accuracy and adhere to the demonstrated model. How to implement the command style? The following steps describe how to use the anatomy of the command style as guidelines for implementation. This process involves the pre-impact, impact, and post-impact decisions. The pre-impact set. The purpose of the pre-impact set of decisions is to plan. During the planning set, all the decisions in the anatomy are made in accordance with the selected teaching learning behavior. Deciding which specific teaching learning behavior to select is determined by making decisions about the objectives for the task and the behavior. The planning will eventually result in a lesson plan. The impact set. The impact set is the actual face-to-face implementation time. The purpose of the impact set of decisions is to engage the learners in active participation and to execute, follow through with the decisions made during the pre-impact. It is the time to put the intent into action. It is imperative in all styles that the expectations be sequenced during delivery in the episode. The learners must know the expectations of the task performance and the expected teacher-learner relationship, roles or decisions of the teacher and learner. Therefore, the teacher is responsible for setting the scene by presenting the expectations during every episode. Setting the scene in any style always includes delivering three sets of expectation. One is the subject matter, the content, and second is the behavior, that is the role or the decisions of the teacher and the learners, and third is logistical procedures, that is equipment, time, location, and other considerations. These three expectations can be delivered in the order that best leads to the anticipated objectives. Expectations about subject matter establish what is to be done. Behavior focuses on how the teacher and learners are expected to look while engaging in the task, that is, behavior image. The logistical procedures indicate the supporting details and parameters for the environment and task. Logistical examples include distribution of equipment, organization of learners, location boundaries, movement patterns from one station to another, time limits, attire and appearance requests, and other tasks or environment parameters. It is important to deliver the three expectations in separate statements or segments rather than mixing them. It is easier for learners to grasp the expectations when they are presented individually. In the initial stages of using the spectrum or any new style, the students will need an introduction to the idea of different teaching learning styles or behaviors. For the first two or three episodes in the style, the teacher could present something similar to the following to prepare the learners for an expanded classroom reality. Initial introduction, roles or the behavior expectations. The teacher explains to the students that when a teacher and student are in a face-to-face situation, a variety of decisions can be made by the teacher or the learner. Number two, these decisions can be distributed between the teacher and the learners in a variety of ways depending on the relationship's purpose at the particular time and the particular episode. Next is, one of these particular arrangements is a relationship where the teacher's role is to make all the decisions and the learner's role is to follow, perform and respond to each decision, each command, that is a stimulus. Next is the purpose of such a relationship called the command style or precision style is to elicit an immediate response so that certain tasks can be learned accurately and in a short period of time. A series of episodes in this style facilitates the accomplishment of objectives such as replication of a model, precision and accuracy of performance, and synchronized performance. Experience with the spectrum styles indicates that most students can internalize the structure and operation of the styles within two or three episodes when the introduction to the styles covers point 1 through 5. Therefore, to set the expectations in subsequent episodes, the teacher announces the name of the style and moves on to the delivery of the sub-initial introduction, that is the subject matter expectation. The teacher demonstrates the whole task, its parts and its terminology. The order here may vary according to purpose. This establishes the model for the performance. The demonstration may be relegated to videotape, pictures or to a student who can perform the task according to the model. The teacher explains the movement sequence or details necessary for efficiency or safely understanding the task. Varying time ratios of demonstration and explanation may be necessary for different tasks. Initial introduction, logistical procedures, expectations. The teacher establishes the preparatory and command signals for the episodes. These may change during the episode to accommodate different aspects of the subject matter. Most episodes require parameters regarding time, location, interval, where to get and return equipment, attire and appearance. Other procedures may be identified depending on the subject matter or behavior expectations. At this point, the teacher and the learners are ready to begin the activity, which is the essence of the impact set. The learners respond according to the command signals and the rhythm support procedures. conducted by the teacher. The post impact set, the post impact set of decisions offer feedback to the learner about the performance of the task and about the learner's role in following the teacher's decision. The command style experience is one of action. The repeated movement in performing each task and replicating the model brings about the contribution of this style to physical development. Passivity is incongruent with the style. In any given episode, the learners use a maximum amount of time in active participation. A minimum amount of time is used by the teacher for delivery of the three expectations: subject matter, behavior, or the role logistics. Active time on task in this style is very high. The implications of the command style. Each style on the spectrum differently affects learners, subject matter selection, and task design. Each style suggests a set of implications. Whenever a command style behavior is used in an episode, it implies that the teacher can design experiences for group synchronization and success. The teacher can design a stimulus response experience that produces developmental benefits. The teacher is aware of the need for conformity to the certain principles for safety or movement proficiency or for accuracy in performance. The teacher is able to develop group cohesiveness. The learners can function and develop physical skills within a stimulus response relationship. The learners are willing to acknowledge their roles and partnerships within the group. The learners acknowledge the teacher's expertise and are willing to accept the teacher's decisions. Now, the subject matter consideration. The overriding purpose of the command style is to develop automaticity of responses or movements. Therefore, content that is performed by what appears to be wired reflexes or instinct requires precision practice of the command style. Aspects of many activities or sports require accuracy and precision in body positions and movements. Fencing, archery, swimming, baseball, proper holding of rackets, clubs, balls, hoops, repetition of basic steps or routine performances all required frequent experience in precision practice. A common assumption in the command precision practice is that overlearning needs to occur to produce automaticity. The following suggestions relate to using the command precision practice. When learners are inexperienced and new to the content, the task should deal with one stimulus at a time, a moving ball but in a stationary position. However, when learners are skilled in the task, focusing their attention on the individual parts of what is already an automatic learned response will disrupt the wired reflex and skill proficiency. When errors are observed in an automatic or wired reflex performance, the performance must be rewired by interrupting the automatic flow of the action by focusing on the flawed section. Relearning is difficult because it emphasizes multiple developmental channels. First, the emotional channel to accept that a known skill must be altered. Then the cognitive channel to understand the differences. And finally, the physical channel to alter a movement pattern. The following guidelines summarize subject matter selection for the command precision style. The subject matter is fixed. It represents a single standard. The subject matter is best learned by immediate recall and through repeated performance. The subject matter can be divided into separate elements that can be replicated by a stimulus response procedure and can be learned in a short period of time. The greater the speed of recall, the more proficient the learner will be in moving on to other aspects of the subject matter. Individual differences are not invited. Instead, replication of the selected subject matter is sought. Through frequent replication, the group can perform the task in unison. So, we have discussed about the command method for physical education in this episode. I hope the information was of some use to all of you. Thank you so much for watching.